All right. So, what was it, Josh?
Come up here.
Have a seat, Miss.
This one, why and how SAR? Why? Because it is actually the natural product with high potential, the therapeutic potential means that it could be a potential become a lead, then it become our, we look at our drugs later.
Yep.
And then how SAR is performed means that we do the interaction, the bonding things.
How do you test for whether alcohol is involved in interaction? How do you know that the methyl group is involved? How do you know the ring is involved?
Oh, means we have to like do docking process.
Docking is one way. It will be the virtual way, but you still have to test it in vitro, as is.
Oh, means that you have to use the bioAC something like that.
Yes, but how do you know? How will you know? It's all in the laboratory. I touch upon it a very few times. So one way I mentioned in my lecture is that if you think that the example I talk about a story of lighting. So that is actually, that's why I say this approach is a reductionist approach. So you have usually a natural products are huge.
Mm-hmm.
Then you, what you do?
We have to do the optimization.
So how do you do that?
So we have to do the receivers and then identify the pharmacophore first.
Okay.
And then we identify pharmacophore means the group that are involved in the SR.
In the interaction.
In the interaction,
yeah.
And then we just optimize it whether we want to do the elongation or rigidification or something.
That would be a bit down the line. So it's somewhere in the middle. So in the beginning you do the interaction first.
Mm-hmm.
Then somewhere in the beginning is that you find out, because if you have a big structure, mm-hmm. The natural products are big, morphine. Lipin is theoretical, it's huge actually. Cocaine, you know. So not all exactly. Before you come to that unit, you have to explain not all are actually involved in an interaction with the receptor.
Some
groups only. So how but the key thing about building the structure activity profile anyway is recorded, so you don't have to worry. You can watch the video later. The main thing is that before you build the profile, it's a profile,
mm-hmm.
is that you need to find out which is essential.
And which not
exactly. So once you know, for example, if there is an aromatic ring, how do I know for sure that it's involved in interaction?
We have to test using the BioAC blocking.
That's one, but BioAC is one. But on the part of MedChem, as the chemist,
mm-hmm.
you would then, if your aromatic ring is okay, I have this aromatic ring, how do I know? Then he would then try to synthesize the compound, for example.
Analog,
exactly.
But that's whether the analog also have activity, means that if the group involved.
Yes, just change one thing only. So maybe you change the aromatic ring to a cyclohexane. The one without a 5-5. So
then retain
activity
means
retain activity means
not involved in the after changing from
exactly
it means that it does not involve
if the activity drops
means it
needs somehow it needs to work. So macam itulah.
Okay.
That would be one example. So macam then later bila dia dah realize okay these are essential, these are not essential. So you try to synthesize the one that with essential, the pharmacophore. Then with this lead molecule, optimize. What do they you try to do the essential structure? You try to elongate. You try to redefine. You understood? Eh? Okay. All right. Good. Okay.
So this also and then the potential. actually they asked actually salt rich, they said because I found out also salt rich is actually is same with the ionic bond.
Salt bridge is a name, is a term given for this organic salt in the body. Somehow is, I think so far yeah I know lah. Maybe the others, the one that I know within my knowledge is between carboxylic acid and RGB. It's always that it's like a triangle like that. It's always like that. Then I would check it. But if it's the carboxylic acid, it's only like that.
Means the term is only used for the organic salt.
Yes. In the body, usually biological interaction. Between amino acids
and also the
carboxylic acid of the drug and receptor. Or within, they also salt bridge within the protein. So that's how you can maintain. That's how if you have a protein enzyme, you can actually maintain its shape.
Very strong interaction.
As it does have a disulfide bond, hydrogen bonding, and also salt suggestion. So this is what
the
name.
So we have to use carefully between these two terms.
Salt bridge is, I think, the strongest. The strongest of all the
interactions.
But essentially it is
sketch and describe the list my other optimization actually for this because for the video actually doctor mentioned about
which video,
the
many videos
ACE inhibitor one.
Which video is my video or your video? My video.
Doctor's video. Actually about the ACE inhibitor one. Then they said good doctor asked in the in the exam
drugs. Yes.
Other drugs also.
Yes.
Yeah. Means that
if it's not in the study guide, don't worry.
Means only in the study guide.
And also my lecture.
And also the lecture.
You have three sources that you can refer to.
Mm-hmm.
One study guide. Study guide.
Mm-hmm.
Online activities.
Yes.
The Facebook.
Okay.
My lecture.
Mm-hmm.
And also
the class activity.
Yes.
Okay.
All that, it can be questions that I post out when I give a lecture. I say, okay, this, try to answer this question. Think about it. Second is, okay, let's do this activity. So, look, tak buat sajalah. Like, actually go around and tengok semua orang kan.
So, means that only those drugs that I mentioned, right? Other drug maybe not
Tapi tadi just another came in and said, you know, in university you are sort of expected to think beyond a bit more, apply a bit more beyond. So if I give you A, B, C,
mm-hmm.
and then I sort of expect you to think of D. Jangan banyak orang buat. I think about 80% would think ABC lah. Tapi you should be able to apply your knowledge into situation D.
Meaning, doctor means that if we are given a
scenario,
ABC, and then we have to think of like how to optimize further into the
optimize. That doesn't have to be optimized. Whatever from ABC,
mm-hmm.
you learn lessons though.
Mm-hmm.
What are the key things, the concept, the principles in A and B and C scenario or drug? Okay, then I give you D. Can you apply this in D? Because D bukan sama saja. Dia bukan sama. You probably have the features of A, B, and C, or C. Can you apply that?
Means that if we are put in different scenario,
similar feature, same principle. Can you apply? Cuma tukar, kadang-kadang dengan feature tukar. Selama ni belajar belajar A, B, and C. Can you apply prinsipal belajar ni dalam this situation?
Application based.
Macam you nak naik gedung Kinabalu tapi you cuma hiking kat sini saja. Boleh apply kan?
Boleh.
That's all. Whatever you practice kat this Bukit Gambo ni, I'm sure you can apply kat Gedung Kinabalu, cuma lebih longer sikit lah. Macam tu lah lebih kurang. So yes, you learn the principles because anyway the whole thing is called principles kan? The principles, concept, the lessons I mentioned about lessons you have to know. So can you apply this
into the real life?
Good, mention drugs. I don't know how many drugs are there. How many drugs are there in the world? In the, on the market?
Too many,
right? Tapi from one or two drugs, you can learn the lessons, essence. How can you apply it in certain things? Macam ionic bonds. Maybe not all drugs have got ionic bond attraction. But you can apply it to other drugs. And say, I see kat bawah sini, I see arginina. That's what I mean. I see alcohol. I see also the other side is apa ni?
Carbonate.
Exactly. Itu je. But then aku tengok, terkejut. That's why I see a lot of students ni. 80% they A, B and C, okay. Then people go, I don't know. They know she didn't even ask me, I know. That's why I see a lot lah in exam. Doctor, they nampak the exam. And then I come up and say, I'm sorry, I cannot answer you today because of the exam.
Yeah.
Okay, macam tu lah. Because sometimes we have to go a bit more beyond the classroom lah.
Macam Doktor cakap semua itu konsep itu ada, cuma kita nak apply
sikit.
Maksud kita kena ada konsep, kena apply, kena understand konsep itu.
And I also want to stretch your mind juga.
Reset bagi dia aktif sikit.
Ada satu saja. Kena buka sikit. Tapi tak dalam macam terus sangat. nanti takut YouTube terus breakdown, you know. Just sikit saja.
Bukanlah macam kami tak sure. Then kami pun tulis je lah.
Tapi understand.
Apa yang kami understand, kita justify
yes.
kita based on our
explain.
And then if it's reasonable and quite okay, then we still can get the credits from it.
Yes, if you are able to, that's I think also another thing in university. You should able to rationalize, justify. Give me your reasoning.
Give the reason.
Logical one. Janganlah goreng. Banyak orang goreng. Tengok-tengok ada orang bagi give me the same thing. I was like, you're not even thinking. You're just
memorizing
and producing saja. Tapi if you really can think and you have tadi kata, you baca, you faham, you understand, and then you explain from your understanding to me. I will accept. Okay, I can see you understand that much, and then I know where you're going. Okay, I can leave marks. Walaupun you kata, sorry doctor, I cannot explain me more. Okay, from C I cannot go to D, but this is what I understand from. I
break it A, B, and C.
And I could break it down like this for this structure, and this is my justification, my rationale, my thinking. Okay, fine. Okay, no problem. I can see that you're thinking. This is what we want to develop.
Because there is no fixed answer scheme for the exam, right?
Answer scheme banyak juga yang tengoklah. I tengok the year juga.
Ada fix. Tapi boleh kalau kami tulis cara kami pun boleh dapat sikit-sikit.
Itu up to the lecturer, I think. I have to say, up to the lecturer. Because it's too rigid pun, it won't be so good. Because different class, different pattern. So, I cannot reveal.
Sorry, asking that.
That is okay.
Okay. And then,
can you explain?
Excellent factors affecting binding interaction in drug is the group, the substituents, and then the orientation, something like that.
So each, how many interactions are there?
First is the orientation is very important.
Bonding. So each one of these are the factors that influence the strength
and also the cognition, the probability.
Yes.
Adhesion bonding, orientation is very important.
Yeah, exactly.
HBA is very important.
And bonding, orientation doesn't matter.
Orientation doesn't matter because it's very strong, so it can
exactly
form.
Bond
yang tak sama ada benda.
Yes. So you have to know the factors that affecting
the strength and also the formation of this bond.
Yes.
Okay. And then describe the how would you study a binding interaction is just now like
how would you study?
Exactly. Okay.
Repeat actually.
Okay. So this
one. Okay. Happy.
Okay.
Alright.
Macam tak ada cakap banyak dah.
Okay.
Yang ACP.
Okay. Alright. is actually, for your information, is partly discovery, partly SAR, and then optimization. Ada tiga stage. That's why I said ACE inhibitors are the classic drug discovery. Then you can see the actually a drug development. Tapi ni ada tiga phase dalam tu yang you can see. So it's a beautiful case study. Because you can see from the start of the
Tera study,
SAR study dalam tu, and then it bought it. That's why I also stop dekat Kepri, I think, I stop dekat Lanna Prill. Tapi kalau you can, there's also the Lanna Prill and also other things yang kalau you baca lagi, you think, oh, it's a beautiful punya
pictures.
Exactly. Or the whole thing.
And then the biotransformation reaction. For this, they asked me, biotransformation reaction is like in the enzyme, like the seed enzyme. Also other enzymes in the body, like esterase.
Yes.
Like
the one that you learn in FAR.
One, four, two. Biochem and pharmacology.
And also another number one, pharmaceutical chemistry.
1414. And then the enzyme is very long, like five.
That one I think not in my chem. My chem is more. This is principles, concept principles. The main thing macam adalah apa ni reductase. Tapi you don't have to know what kind of reductase reduction ni. Tapi macam oxidation. Tapi you don't have to know what kind of oxidation. Itu I think lebih pada pharmacology.
So we just talk about maybe like this very general reduction of this group, oxidation of this group is enough already.
Yes. Usually yes.
And then enzyme reductase, oxidase. Okay. If we don't know maybe
because actually in our body the reductase, oxidase, dehydrogenase, all of these like seed enzyme like seed 4-5-0.
And ada juga dia punya nama-nama kan. Banyak lagi nama lah. Tapi I'm not too concerned about that because I think I want to have a bigger picture lah. The principles lah. The concept
principle,
of
the general principle,
yes.
And then we just have to apply.
Because so many nanti I think too many. Because the thing is, again, I mean, too many drugs out there. Too many enzymes. I think and then the course is limited for a few weeks. You know, 14 weeks, 16 weeks.
Impossible.
So I think the main thing is the concept, the principles. Lah.
We can just identify and then
Main thing identify first.
Identify.
I tengok banyak orang yang tak sure lagi.
Ni
apa ni saya tak tahu. I don't know. Ionic ke? Ionic jembon.
Itu penting. Because they actually later they ask me to confirm the hydrogen bonding with doctors.
Okay.
So this one I think is for the like toxicity associated metabolites or metabolism. Like because for each drug there are actually like for Panadol also there are many metabolites and only one or few of the metabolites is toxic. Yeah. And then this is very specific, so we just have to know the examples of the
drug. The one I mentioned in my lecture. Remember what I mentioned in my lecture?
For the Panadol one, yes. ACE inhibitor.
Lagi?
Lupa dah.
Tak apa, you baca.
Okay, so baca.
Tapi dalam tu, itu ada lagi in my lecture.
So, example, won't go beyond like other drugs.
If you want to go beyond, tak apa. If you feel that from other causes, because I don't want to limit it in a sense. The one I highlighted, that's fine. Yeah, you can remember. But if you have learned from other causes,
like from the 2-4-1 antimicrobe, right?
Okay.
We learned from Dr. Aisha also for the current people. Like we know that the benzene ring had a glutathione cleansing ring heterocycles, NS and a nitro group that are actually potentially toxic.
Exactly, that's fine.
That's fine.
So
tapi
you have to, let's just work it out. Kenapa dia toxic? Kenapa dia?
Dia nitro
group
can cause something.
Okay, it can reduce to
NH2,
NH2 example. Then okay. It can go beyond, because I don't want to, the EK is a big thing. I wouldn't go into detail exactly. Tapi I have provided you guys with some examples yang really I think is classic juga lah. People has been classic lah. But if you, as you go along, you learn from clinical pharmacy, I'm sure there are more.
Yeah.
If you want to put in, tak apa. I have research lah. This example you use in this to answer my question is it looks okay appropriate? Okay, markup, because the question I ask in general. Problem in solubility. There's many things that can be insoluble, poorly soluble.
Yeah.
If you give me a good example, you explain. You should cerita lah. Apa benda ni? Kenapa dia ni? What is the problem? Due to what? Which group? You know exactly what you're talking about, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Then you give solution. Even solved by using other functionality, I mean, that's fine.
Oh, but I would like to ask about the just now. Your question will be some questions will be general, explain
mixture.
If you are asked to explain the solubility problem in drugs,
okay.
Then we will give one example of drug.
Okay.
And then we have to draw out the structure.
If you think it will clarify, then
we have to draw it.
Yes.
If we don't know the structure, then better.
If you forget, you know, sometimes people panic. Then you go panic. Tak apa, itu list apa yang boleh tulis. Tapi tengoklah kalau if I ask specifically, use the structure. Use the structure given. Then you have to
use
lah.
Okay. If
refer to structure.
If generally, then
explain only, describe only. Then boleh lah. I think boleh dikira juga lah. Tapi maybe not as much marks compared to if you give me a structure, and you do okay. This particular part is involved. Semua orang takut structure ya. It's a beautiful example.
Then, about the C lock.
Me okay, the Miski okay.
Lipsinki okay.
Are we not?
Because the Lipsinki only because only the four rules,
mm-hmm.
Right? Hydrobone accepted not more than 10, then hydrobone not more than 5,
okay.
And then MCOMU should be less than 500.
Okay.
Then the C lock B completed lock B value should be less than 45.
Alright.
Okay. And then they said only the things here is like the limitations of rules of five. Means that is actually rules of five is does the did not consider the ionization.
Okay.
Did not consider the ionization, and then it does not consider the rotator bone.
Yeah, applies to I don't know how many percent. I would say most of drugs, but there are also drugs with higher molecular weight. I mentioned that cyclosporine, 1,000, but it's still a drug.
Still.
So how can you explain that? Because you limit it up to 500. Tapi does it mean that kalau more than 600, 700 and so on, which are other drugs then, they're not drugs. They are not already available. Except cyclosporine is an oral, both oral and any, so oral injection. So how can you explain that? That's when the rotatable bones comes in, when the PSA comes in, because the limitation of Lipinski is that you can only explain up to 500, up to the hydrogen bonding. Tapi there are also other drugs that
other factors that can affect the absorption.
Also yes, and also other factors that other drugs that sort of exceptional to the rule. They don't follow the rule.
Is that they actually like mimics the nutrient.
They could be made with neutral, exactly. They use other ways to get in.
To get in. Means that they have transporter.
Could be, yes, could yes, be. Exactly. So they don't follow that rule. So those who don't follow, this is the for those follow the rule, and the group which don't follow the rule. So people ask, so what happened to this? What are the other principle or other similar concept that you can apply to this one and that follow? People want to find a way to, because end of the day, they want to have a set rule. That, okay, you have these rules, this goes into my plan, drug development. If they don't follow this rule, what will happen? You know, but still they cannot just stack up, because imagine as people sensitive thing, a lot of money, they cannot just stack up. Okay, what happened to this drug? So can we do something about this?
So they
have to optimize it. But they have to find a rule that say, okay, this one, but how far you want to optimize it? Again, the effort, but then you have to think about what? You have to try and
change the group of administration.
Exactly. So at what point do you say, okay, we have to stop at this stage of the drug development, and then don't change the drug structure, but we do the reformulation and so on. So they have to find a way that you say A, B, and C.
Like doctor said, like, for
sub-formation, the solubility problem. Yeah. So, sub doesn't work, then move on to the next one. This one, work and move on. Tapi kalau it works at the knee, okay, tak apa.
Okay.
Then happy lah. Macam tu lah, just find a way to ni. Tapi itu delivery lah.
Okay.
Delivery.
Okay. So, C-Log-B and Ampere-Lemke formula,
mm-hmm.
actually, if like the structure, they have contradiction, means that C-Log-B said, okay, it's not a big problem,
mm-hmm.
Because it's
so
less than 0.5, then it's okay. And then the Lemke's one, as long as the solubility potential is higher than the number of carbon, that is okay.
Okay.
If one said okay, one not okay, then how should be explained in the
question. You need to explain, you just report on it.
Oh, just report.
You just say that Lemke is predicted as insoluble,
but
C-Log-B is
insoluble. That's enough. Oh, we don't have to draw out a conclusion.
It's a theoretical.
Because no problem, them are theoretical.
The determining factor is they have to test it on the bench. It's in practice, in the lab.
For the chemical modification, like bioisosteres, the salt thing, the cycle, that string thing, do we have to memorize the examples?
What examples?
The drugs.
What drugs?
Like for the
take
salt
one or two
formation.
La.
Or take one.
Take one or two. La. I think the one, I know there's a lot, but just take one or two. La. I think that would be enough for me. La, I think.
Okay.
Just example, yeah, post-solubility, what can you do with it? But then to general, tapi you can just follow, one way you can follow that, step by step. First is to do the salt, kalau solubility is found out that it's actually between, that's what you want, then you go to salt formation, okay, maybe example lagi lah, it's CL,
okay,
boleh. If you want to combust less acid, then sodium salt.
Yeah, it can be the latest. So like in the same question, because for the things it's like a flow chart. If we answer in flow chart but in full sentence complete, then you will still get the marks, or we have to answer in paragraph form.
Oh, so your concern is whether to write an essay. For me, I can accept that, because I'm a visual person, so I accept flow chart, diagram, structures. Yeah, it's easy because it's somehow a lot of things. You don't have, hello, you you have a structure. You describe a structure. You have this ring connect to the hexagon. Ah, it's a long winded thing.
Yeah.
Draw structure. Your drawing is nothing simpler kalau you boleh lah. Then I can accept point form. No problem. Don't have to. I think some lectures ask for essays, for sentence and everything. I then accept point form.
Okay. Then, yeah, that's
end 2-1-2. Okay, alright. So if you find some examples in 2-4-1 that you can use in, you know, 2-1-2, okay.
Or
even 1-1-4. I use some of the example from 1-4-1, the PNS.
The
cocaine, adrenaline, macam tu lah. Jadi, you can, whatever ni, try to find what is the lesson I learned from there. And if you feel that it's applicable,
then just put it. So,
Wow. Busy one. Busy notes, eh?
No. Okay, doctor, about this, they asked me the structure.
Mm.
Do they have to?
No, don't worry.
No worry.
Too big. I cannot remember as well.
Yeah,
so don't worry.
Don't worry. This one, lincomycin.
Lincomycin. 2-4-1. Don't worry about structures. Kalau keluar, ada structure.
Keluar, ada structure.
Yes.
Oh, very good.
Even in the quiz as well. Ada structure.
Like simple,
like
sulfanilamide, we have to draw
our own. Okay, the aspirin punya base, macam we have a benzoic acid, macam tu sulfanilamide, I think that one is very simple lah. I do expect you to know. Tapi the big one macam the three rings, nitromycin, ada ni, 2-3 ring tu, I think I don't expect you to know. One ring tu, I expect you lah.
Okay.
At least one ring.
Penicillin,
itu penting, itu memang.
Itu memperhatikan dia sakit kecil dan kena rumah.
Ya, itu. No, I think that is the
classic and very fundamental thing.
The first antibiotic.
Yeah. Penicillin.
A pharmacist cannot not know.
Double
negative, cannot not know.
They
have to know that.
Okay.
The penicillin, because it's the first one of the first antibiotic. It's like a medical drug. Back then, it's huge. So you have to know.
Okay.
Yang lain-lain kemudian tu apa? I think I
boleh. Tak apa, kita kena tahu macam epimerization yang dalam table yang Dr. bagi.
Yes.
And then cytomycin.
This one tadi, if you see, there's not much chemistry, kan? It's more of the is structure dia.
SAR.
SAR sikit lah. Sikit, SAR mana? SAR ni tak ada sangat. Few lah, few.
Mungkin related to toxicity.
Ini sikit lah. Tapi tak banyak. It's more on the where are the sugar? What sugar?
Yeah. What sugar? Do you have to memorize the name of the sugar?
Because sugar as yes, that one you have to skip. Yes.
Means that you give like this structure, we have to know. Okay, this sugar is D X. This sugar is this. Oh.
I will ask.
Okay.
But because they not much chemistry, that's why.
Oh, okay.
So my question actually quite limited. I ask you what sugar je? What? Not how.
Okay.
Macam penicillin
first level. Okay.
First level macam mana? How does it? How does hypersensitivity act?
For example, for the hypersensitivity things. Because it actually it will form complex with the IgE and then cause hypersensitivity reaction. So when do we have to describe the hypersensitivity? Means that we have to describe penicillin, the metabolite of penicillin is mimics
Can I press your penicillin?
Penicillin, yeah.
Thank you.
Dr. Matana.
Saya pun lupa wait aja.
Saya looking at pagi
999 tau. 999. Help me, help me.
Help me.
Okay. I did this one. Oh, you have another one. Okay, mana-mana. But I'm looking for this one. Dia, macam ni, Penisley, if, macam mana kata?
The metabolite.
Usually, penicillin, if you see, as you have, actually, in the lecture, and you have also mentioned that it's quite active with other brain strains.
Yeah.
Okay. Dia, that Artemis is one lah, taking from the PDC or Yoshi group actually. Yeah, I'm trying to remember. Normally you wouldn't get involved, but when you have a nickel file, sometimes, yeah. Yeah, I faham. For example, some drugs, even penicillin itself lah, can cause hypersensitivity because it can actually bind to antibodies. Tapi when binding, somehow, it becomes an entirely new entity yang our body recognizes as foreign entity. And faham lah? Okay, correct me. Because ini only my memory. So what happens is that it may have a necrophile that can actually just attack the ring. Yeah, I faham gitu lah. Somehow. I think so that's how dia boleh attack this way lah yang I faham. Tapi honestly, I don't make sense at to you lah. So can you read Graham Patrick? I think there's a paragraph on that that mentioned about hypersensitivity.
Okay, after I read it and that I reconfirm that within this week.
This week.
Okay.
Tapi I think it's because then.
Then after confirming, I can post it on the Facebook group.
If you want to, yes.
Okay.
Sure. But that's the ni lah. Yeah, I faham. Dia macam the foreign entity is. It can then trigger off the activation problem. And then never mind. You go and read.
Okay.
Okay. Penicillin can form the IG and it will then attack.
Actually, pharmacology is quite very short list actually.
So this one the penicillin and protein. Okay. Usually antibody lah. If IG is, you can about antibody.
Immunoglobulin.
Yeah.
And then just
the
little shock. And it's
hypersensitive. It's like very shock.
And we check first that the graphic if that is at the chemistry involved then.
Usually because this complexion in IG, what happens is that so IG it can be a protein. It can be any protein ke? So a protein that has a necrophile somehow, mungkin I don't know what kind of protein lah, very general. Anything with a necrophile can attack the penicillin. Anything yang mungkin terkeluar somewhere ada profile yang tak in the near, it can probably attack penicillin. So what happens is this complexion, these two complex thing is actually considered as a foreign entity in the body.
Yeah.
Very big and everything. Tapi bila you ada IgE dengan penicillin ujung tu, then ada broken off. Kalau dia ni broken off, it can be bayangkan it can be this part kerja yang melekat pada dia IG. So our body take it as a foreign thing, alien. So they do attack lah.
Doctor, that's a question. Maybe it's somehow like not related.
Sure.
But for this penicillin hypersensitivity, only cause the some certain people only, right? Then others people know normal, healthy, then no. Then we also have protein, they also have protein. Why?
Our body are different. I think our body, not all, well, upon the drugs, that is, have you heard of personalized medicine?
Yeah.
So that is when they consider your DNA and so on. Because our body, walaupun the way we do the things is actually sama-sama.
But the protein profile and the DNA profile is actually different.
That's why some people, macam I, sunburn, so when you okay, you know. Jadi macam tu, jadi dia how we, in general, we have the baseline. Mm-hmm. We can all, if you have infection, you can give antibiotic. If you have regular DNA, tapi I think at some point, some drugs, you can see some patient, they won't respond to some drugs. Or they have this problem.
This problem.
Yes. Another
like enzyme, we have slow acetylator, fast acetylator.
Exactly, the enzyme. Okay. Another yang, tapi not talking about drug. Another thing yang mungkin, have you heard of gluten?
Gluten, G-L-U-T-N.
It's a protein. It's a protein from bread.
Yeah.
This morning. I was eating the bread. I saw the ingredient. Gluten. Okay.
A
bit gluten.
Ah, okay. You okay kan? Orang lain okay kan? Tapi there's a minority of people yang allergic to gluten. Cannot eat bread. Cannot eat anything with gluten. Anything ni, no gluten. Kalau you go to somewhere, you should organic shop lah. No gluten. Rice is okay, rice is not gluten. The protein is different. So, why? And then I feel like, you see, you're actually quite recent. I think, remember, gluten is a problem. We have been eating bread for centuries. Rupanya, I think, because of the GMO, genetically modified organism and organically produced product. Yeah. Nowadays, there's a lot of wheat, soybean, and so on. That changes the protein. And one of the protein that change over time because of the GMO product is gluten. So that's not only one gluten. There's
a variety.
And rupa-rupanya orang yang allergic to gluten are the one that allergic to this variety.
Means only the one type of the...
No, but only the one type?
Only one type of the gluten or all types of gluten.
I think there are a few yang dia memang allergic. Rupanya dia not only one type. I think dulu only one type. Tapi now is that the...
More
than one type. So they now they one that allergic ni, dia allergic semua lah. Dia tak boleh dah.
Cross.
Exactly. I just realized, it's actually a big issue now. It's not a small minority now. Because dia macam, you see a lot of people, I think especially Western, they have a bit more bread. Kita ada mixture. Exactly. You don't really hear people allergic to the gluten in Malaysia as much. We have weird name. Over there, it's a big problem. Exactly. So dulu when I was younger, no peanuts. Again, protein, no peanuts, ataupun
no eggs.
No eggs. Normal that. No eggs. So I think it's similar to this, lah.
This. So then I check on the cartridge again, and then if there is somehow, then I will inform you.
Okay. Let me know.
Okay, because this is too general.
Too general, yes.
Okay. And then for this structure, and then
this structure.
they
just tell them don't worry too much.
Don't worry too much. Actually, they asked me about the inherent chemistry. Let me see the
pictures.
Inherent chemistry, like if they don't understand.
Inherent chemistry of what?
Of aminoglycoside. This one is too small. This one is screenshot one.
Mana at least inherent?
Inherent chemistry. What is this made of? The similarity between the structure and
inherent chemistry is the chemistry that inherent is always about the inside. You have how many families? Four families of glycoside, three families. So what are the common chemistry? The one that so it's the glycoside chemistry.
Like it must be amino sugar.
and then the glycoside in here of one sugar and
a glycol, yeah. So what is the chemistry in there? What is the common chemistry, the same chemistry across all the families? Mm-hmm. Is
the sugar.
I did. If you see here, there's no chemistry so much. It's not like chemistry. It's not like macam doxycycline.
Yeah.
You talk about this again. In here, actually we talk about glycoside. It's actually because actually we change it. It's actually unstable to acid.
Yes.
Itu je. I didn't mention because I thought you would know.
No.
General ether.
Because the ether group and the glycoside bond, yeah, is then.
Because of that is this part is having. This is interesting. Once you have this, mm-hmm. and with this, they create a different chemistry. Because I believe glycochemistry. Just a simple ring with this going to have different chemistry. So from here you look at ether, but then actually it has different chemistry from other stuff. But tak apa, as you know, just for your information, this one kalau in a strong acid or strong alkaline, definitely it's no longer glycoside, it will become real part.
The glycoside and the sugar. Okay. So this one in strong alkaline also it can.
Macam you, I think you learn in 1-1-3 kot. The fish apa ni?
Official projection.
Official projection. Tapi itu belajar juga glucose kan? Ada macam
ada glucose.
The chemistry belajar sikit tak? Tak belajar.
Sugar chemistry macam.
How does it form the ketal, hemiacetal? And then it's a reversible reaction. Dia macam. You can have the fish bone tea.
Mm-hmm.
So then he actually form a bond and acetal to become a sugar. So one way to show is fish bone. Second way to show is this way. It's just a presentation. Tapi that is a hemiacetal condition. Jadi that is the chemistry actually. Then he that's what I mean inherent chemistry. But the rest are the chemistry bone.
And then the last question that they ask is
finish.
Last question for the last one, sulfonamide. And then they actually asked me then they said the key focus part for the important parts for the sulfonamide.
Cut the lump to it. It's not in the essential thing.
It's not in the essential diagram.
Tak ada ya? Okay. Alright.
So maybe
my mistake lah. I should have put in. Tak ada nanti ya?
Tak ada lah.
Okay.
Maybe doctor after confirm, maybe I could help doctor to put on in my.
Tak apa, boleh tak? Anda pun boleh. You just, I think you can post kan dalam Facebook.
Okay. So we confirm. First one is the mechanism of action of the supplement.
Okay.
Means that we have to know the mechanism. Means that the folic synthesis pathway and then where it's at on.
You don't have to know the pathway.
Don't have to
memorize the pathway. Okay. You have to know pathway.
Okay.
At least you know. I don't know the pathway. Of, I know this is folic synthesis pathway.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't have to memorize it. Don't have to memorize it.
It's
like
we can identify it then. It's enough.
Yes. Don't have to memorize it like a Krebs cycle. No. You know where it acts, and how is the formula? The one that come out in the quiz lah.
Okay.
Tak banyak orang boleh jawab.
Untuk Pak Dr. Aisyah, saya rasa untuk last quiz tu sebenarnya boleh buat. Macam sebenarnya sebenarnya itu pun boleh buat. Cuma masa itu
too short
because first is hari tu. Kami ada orang mereka akan lari dari duty kerana combo week.
Okay, tak kena lari lah.
Kami lari dan masuk dan dia pun macam
then many, there are many questions and then some parts. Your part is actually quite okay.
Okay.
We can tackle.
Oh, tapi yang, are there many parts?
Ha, many
yang
parts.
To enforcement too.
Ha, ha. Then, so we actually mess up and then, for me, when the doctor he does, sharp. Oh, you have 10 more minutes. I'm still doing on one part only. Oh, my God, 10 more minutes. So I just, yeah. And then the doctor, prof side, thing part, true force, it's like gambling, you know. It's more
gambling.
Two or four. It's like we see the question. It's like in the class. It's presented very easily. Very easy. It's like very easy only.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
The question.
Yes.
It's not cephalosporin. It's cephalosporin. Then another one. Very specific. This drug has this interaction. True force.
So
it's like
so you that's what I go baca yeah. But I think what some of you actually brought the notes to the convo and revise.
And revise, yes.
From the
class. Yeah, so many things. So then after that Dr. Hida said the first quiz are not really good.
Then
okay.
we know that
yeah, usually second one is better. When is it? Quiz habis? Dah habis kan? Dah habis lah. Yang coming soon?
Ada kawasan tadi.
Okay, tak dengar tak apa.
Yeah.
I think a bit too many kot. Macam dia masa.
Masih penting dia sedari di cover tu different drugs, they may have like inherent chemistry,
but
somehow
very specific.
Very specific things,
But you have more. I think don't worry too much. I mean, you will see more in the fourth year.
Yeah, in the fourth year.
Fourth year be okay.
So it's like a stone is a yeah.
Never mind. The incoming ni apa dia? Chris ni?
Chris in out. Coming tomorrow is biofarm.
Oh.
English.
Oh,
then
English.
Thursday is the FIFA.
FIFA?
Physical pharmacy.
Okay, physical pharmacy. Okay, that one okay, good. I think physical pharmacy.
Okay. But only one quiz, so it covers from the beginning to the end.
Alright.
So it's like all the parts. So,
macam exam juga lah.
Macam exam, jadi semua orang macam.
Kena
banyak. And then biofarm, nasib baik. Kena yang lain sudah cover quiz.
Sudah cover quiz.
Yeah, itu tinggal tu.
Both that.
Both. And then the binding to the enzyme important. That how is bound.
Because the one is SAR.
Yeah,
and
the SAR.
The thing.
So the structure.
Yeah.
Structure.
Yes. Because then it relates to the SAR.
Okay. Improvements.
Improvement, yes.
And then if they are reversible,
Kidney problem. Because it's insoluble.
Yeah,
because
it's precipitate.
So that what remember the changes in medication.
Okay. So toxicity.
Itu memang klasik lah.
Klasik.
Asyik lah. Soalan yang sangat ni, sebab lama, I think
straight forward
je.
Okay.
I think to me, metastasakrin is the most. And I think
metastasakrin because many reactions, so we have to be careful of that. So, lastly, third Aisha, do you have any advice to give us?
Dah bagi dah banyak kali.
Dah bagi dah banyak kali. Okay.
So just make sure you read the question because this will be different.
Oh, okay. But still, as we cover the notes,
the past year tu rasa kali ni tak payah tengok lah.
Okay,
so it's a good thing you actually come and see me because we have discussed a lot. I think you covered both of the bases and you have covered the study guide. Cuma I think tu lah, because this year it'll be slightly different from last year's.
Means that the question is?
Year A, B and C, D tu.
Oh, D itu.
Oh, okay. Tak payah tanya lagi, dah faham kan? D itu. Okay, faham lah.
Hmm.
Okay.
So, I hope you don't get
jump to second
level. 1.5 lah, bukan level 2 lah. 1.5 lah. Tapi tu lah. I cuma tengok banyak orang yang juga dia hafal this one saja. I cuma takut dia bila dia naik to level 1.5 dia macam kabra, dia terus panik, dia terus nervous, dia terus dia cuma just make sure you have faith that you have learned everything lah sebenarnya. You have faith that you have actually, you know, we've gone through the whole course with us, Dr. William and myself, and then you've done exercises, you've seen the online painting, you know, we had lecture. Cuma either you have to put in the effort to revise and read a bit more from the bracket itu, case studies and apa, penting. So, but have faith that you should be able to answer. I'm confident you can answer.
For the 2-1-2.
2-4-1. 2-4-1 pun sama juga.
Pun sama juga. Pun D juga.
1.5 lah. D tu dah sikit saja. Dia bukan apa. I didn't go to G, you know. Just a sikit lagi je.
Sikit
saja.
Okay, faham.
Because I think you should be able to test you sikit on that.
Yeah.
Tapi there is a mixture. Kalau you want to you want to sini, cakap dia macam apa dia? It's actually a mixture, general and specific. So that ada balance lah. Kalau general sangat tak elok, kalau special sangat, nanti you pening tadi kan. So it's a mixture. And then kedua pula, the style of questioning is not like the past years. So kalau you been doing exercises from the past years tu, some of it actually either buat the revise new, something new this time. Tapi the principle are there.
Okay,
principles still there. Still there. Tak ada beza. The way I asked you the question aja.
Okay. Then doctor, this week, doctor last. Next week, doctor on. Next week still on.
The last 2 weeks are 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
So I'll see you on second. Second is 2-4-1.
Oh yeah.
I'll see you on the second and the fourth.
And the fourth, yeah, two,
so
one.
So if on the first you say, there's somebody cry and say, doctor, I need help.
And then
I think okay, I have confidence that you actually can do it. Boleh, boleh buat.
Can. Yes,
we believe.
Boleh.
Have faith.
Yeah,
on yourself.
Faith.
Yes.
Just tell them.
You have faith on you.
Exactly. I think so.
Okay.
No problem.
Okay.
Tapi jangan tak baca langsung.
Okay, tak baca tak payah lah.
So, actually, I understand they all macam paper ni keluar. I don't know. The next 2 days, they baca. Macam mana? They all plan for themselves. Kata dah paper ni akan keluar awal. Ada 2 papers. Dia akan revise dulu yang the later one. Ini dia akan tinggal lagi 3 hari baru dia revise. I don't know, some people say macam tu ni, macam tu lah.
Because for me,
you mungkin lain, style lain. You
malas. Jadi kan macam, saya ada yang device. Saya macam sekarang, supaya besok saya faham kan. Saya belum sentuh lagi.
Bila you sentuh?
Nanti
bila? Petang.
Pagi.
So besok pagi baru faham, petang baru you revise. Similar.
Because for me it's like actually I know the things.
You have the idea.
I have the idea.
You have your map.
I have the map and then I know already just to go and look through and then know something and write something.
I believe you have done like okay, the fourth revision. Okay. Terus some people actually baru second time tau. Itu yang I think last semester kita kan kita lost number juga dekat breakdown. Tak boleh buat langsung.
Susah.
Dia kena banyak kali kan.
Macam setahu saya, saya bukan saya memang buang banyak masa dalam satu topik. Tapi saya macam bukan saya hafal. Tapi saya buat soalan sendiri. Macam saya copy style tengok soalan dia. Saya buat soalan sendiri. Jadi saya sendiri try balik.
Okay, dengar tu, tu itu T punya secret tu.
Jadi apabila doktor cakap, doktor akan telur D tu, saya macam ada hati nak pergi tengok pasien.
Apa soalan you?
Then saya synthesize.
Apa soalan you?
Apa soalan?
Apa soalan you? Kita baca apa soalan you?
Baca macam.
You try to anticipate apa soalan yang akan keluar. Yang jatuh lah in your mind lah.
Yes, and then I think doing question is easy lah. Because for us to understand, and then by doing the question, you think macam ada salah ni. You can check balik. Thank you, Dr.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, yeah.
Sorry, saya pakai.
Tak apa, boleh share ni.
Boleh. Tak share kan pada mana?
YouTube. My YouTube.
Okay.
Honestly, I have confidence that you guys can actually do it. I have no worries. Have faith that you can answer the question. Yeah.
Okay.
I have faith. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Alright. Thank you.